Where's the economy? You are thinking that temple is also a place like your house or theater or something else. You are thinking that the time spent here in the temple is equal to the time spent in your recreation or relaxation. You are thinking that the money spent here is equal to the money expenditure you are doing that. So in order to remove that nuisance, we want to say about the speciality of the temple zone. Temple zone is having, just as you are having refrigerator, which maintains a constant different temperature, which is not available in the external atmosphere. Refrigerator, it gives certain temperature to the inner ingredients, and air conditioner provides the same facility to an inner room, totally different from even the red hot summer climate which is there outside. So it is known as a contrary provision. Like the temple, in spite of its location, proximity, vicinity, similarity, identity and resemblance with all other utility sources that we are do, it is totally different, distinct and transcendental. The place here is a shelter from where you can just drive out all of your fears, all of your phobias. The problem is, most of the people, they don't know how to manage the temple. I'm giving you a computer with all informations. If you don't know the activation of the computer, what is the use of the computer? I'm giving you all sophisticated tools. If you don't know the manual of operation, how you can get the benefits from that? Totally impossible. I'm giving you a checkbook. If you don't know what the provisions of drawing are, the methodology of drawing the money from the bank, you don't know the location, you don't know the approachability and other things, how you can get money from the bank? So everything is methodology. Temple is a source of power, source of solace, source of knowledge. Whatever we are struggling, whatever we are suffocating, whatever we have been dreaming, whatever we have been neglected, rejected, drowned, driven out and kicked and knocked out in the world, everything you can get in abundance in a temple. Yes, but unfortunately, yes, we don't know that it is a treasury of what we want. We think that we are contributing to temple without knowing temple is contributing to you. We're thinking that we are supporting the temple instead of knowing the temple is supporting. If a person knows proper temple management, 1 hour of a person's fruitful residence, systematic residence inside a temple is more than enough to carry 10 years of successful and powerful life in all of his various walks of life. Economic, academic, industrial, social, each and every walk of human life where people are dreaming, where people have surrendered to the threshold of unworthy rascals and scoundrels for getting benefits, they should surrender unto the worthy feet of the Lord, who is our real relative and who is the responsible and liable person for each and every bit of our development and improvement. So we should understand the greatness, the simplicity, supremacy and benevolence that is there within the Lord, and see how we can be fortunate enough to be a proper receptor of His mercy, for which He has been already a bounteous reservoir. So we should understand how to get that. How to get that? Think of the association of good people. Meditate for half an hour. Discuss about the temple and the development. You are traveling to the temple for at least 2 days. Going back, you will be traveling for 2 days. You are inside the temple just for 2 or 3 hours. Within this time frame, how much you have thought about God? How much you have thought about your divine unity? How much you have thought about your faults and rectification? How much you have thought about your clandestine nature and falsity? How much you have thought about your reforms and renaissance? It is not there. So take a proper guide, take a proper manual methodology, and see that each and every foot that we are making towards the temple is nothing but a charger. There was a scientist, he is an energy scientist, he is very famous for energy parsimony. Whenever you open the door, immediately there will be a link to the energy charger. If you open the door, there will be energy charge in the battery. If somebody walks, there are a lot of small receivers kept inside the floor. If you walk inside the house, you walk, then the visitors walk, even they walk inside the house, everything will be charging the battery, which is activating all the solar panels, so that the person's electricity or energy need is highly, it is provided by all of these external energy management. So a person who is a good energy saver converts each and every inch of movement or motion by closing the door, opening the door, taking something, placing something, walking, knocking, riding, running, everything is converted into energy. Like that, we should be a clever and prudent authority of energy conservation, reservation, application. Whatever we smell here, whatever the breeze that we are taking, the respiration, everything is fully forceful, resourceful and powerful. We should understand that. If you properly understand, any beggar coming inside will leave as an emperor. Any dependent coming here will be so bounteous, so that he can take care of innumerable dependents for the nation, for the welfare of the globe, for institutional development, organizational enrichment, etc. So considering innumerable provisions that God has provided for our development, we should be very much thankful each and every second for his shower of mercy, for which we don't deserve at all. We don't serve, neither serve nor deserve. So that much we should be very much thoughtful as well as thankful for his bounteous shower, and we should continue to shower our own affection in the form of unconditional service to him, his inmates and associates by all possible means. I wish and pray.